Hey, what's up? This is Mikey for Electrek, and in this video, we're going to take a look at the Eahora SnowX6. Thanks for watching Electrek. Give us a thumbs up, hit the subscribe button, and enable notifications so that you don't miss out on any videos. The Eahora X6 is a fun little e-bike, and it takes a very interesting electrical concept and puts it into a versatile and fun bike for riding, scooting, or anything else that you want to throw at it. The folding frame is nice. I've put this bike in the trunk a few times and it's a piece of cake. The bike is medium for its size, you know, made for the greatest appeal, but since it's a folding bike, the handlebars are a bit far from the seat. They do telescope up and down, but not front to back. Now, mechanically, the bike has some capable components. A Shimano Altus derailleur is acceptable for this kind of bike. The gear range is somewhat limited, but the hydraulic disc brakes really stand out at this price point. Although it's a folding bike, it feels all right just pedaling normally without the motor. Now, the grips have a slightly ergonomic edge, and the seat is pretty comfy, which is really nice combined with the high air volume of the tires. And yes, I had a lot of fun riding in the snow on this bike. The low center of gravity and the throttle really saved the day, and it made this a dream to ride in the fresh powder of the neighborhood. Now, electrically, the bike is actually quite interesting. The 48-volt 13-amp-hour battery is tucked in the frame pretty nice. Now, I didn't think that they would fit that much in there, but they did. Now, the wires and cables are routed outside of the bike, so that's part of it. The 350-watt motor felt pretty powerful to me. It was more like a 500-watt motor. I wouldn't say it is, but it felt pretty good. Now, this bike is equipped with a cadence-based pedal assist system with a sensor in the bottom bracket. But honestly, I used a lot of the throttle. I would pedal like normal and use the throttle because that's where it just seemed the most fun. Now, the display is pretty big and it's easy to use. Now, this is all well and good, but where the bike really stands out is the energy recapture feature that Eahora calls E-Pass. Now, Eahora, which stands for Energy Ahora, is implementing a new technology that they're pursuing a patent for. This technology will recapture downhill energy and reroute it back into the battery pack. This adds charge back into the pack as it rides downhill. Now, it's not regenerative braking since it's not tied to the brakes at all, but when you ride the bike, it feels like it is braking, so it kind of feels similar. Riding down a hill feels like normal, there's really no change, until you set the pedal assist for level 0, and then the bike will automatically recapture downhill energy when coasting over about 14 miles an hour. At that point, you'll feel the bike slow down on its own, and you'll see the odometer change to show incoming watts into the battery pack. It really does this too, I've tried it. Now, how much does this really add? Well, it's hard to say. A normal range test trying to kill the battery is fraught with all sorts of variables. Testing the energy recapture feature is even more subject to the whims of the environment. So I did one test, one time. I only have this one test, this one point of data, so make of it what you will. I had a starting voltage on the battery of 47.8 volts. I pedaled to speed and then continued pedaling to maintain the recapture mode as I went down a hill that was 0.46 miles long, so almost half a mile. The ending voltage by the time I got to the bottom of the hill was 48.1, so that's 0.3 volts that was added over the course of this small one-time test, which by the way occurred at about 32 degrees Fahrenheit. So what does this all mean? If you have a pretty big and predictable hill on your commute or route you enjoy, then this could help you recharge a tiny bit back to add more length to your total ride. Does this concept work? Yes, it works. Is it practical? Well, that's entirely up to you. One thing I really enjoy about this cool tech is that it doesn't carry a high price. Eahora is quite upfront that this technology is equipped on accessible bikes with accessible pricing. They don't act like it belongs on some Ferrari or justify something with overpriced carbon fiber or nothing like that. The folks at Eahora genuinely seem interested in making a practical bike that people will use. I think that this tech has a long way to go before it changes the world. However, being equipped on a low-priced bike with some acceptable features and uses, I'm really happy that this tech can get more miles from real riders and help improve the tech in the real world. I'll definitely be keeping an eye on this tech and Eahora because I'm excited to see where it goes. So there's my two cents on it, but what do you think? Let me know in the comment section below. Thanks for watching Electrek, and I will see you guys on the later.